We welcome to the studio the Hudson Valley-based singer-songwriter with strong ties to our valley, Dar Williams.
With 15 solo albums and 5 books under her belt, Dar Williams can now add Benefit Concert Impresaria to her resume with the second annual, right? Second? Yep. Rivers and Roads Festival happening at Millside Park in East Hampton tomorrow.
Thanks for coming, Dar Williams.
Thank you.
Let's hear a song and then we'll chat.
All right, here we go.
There was a time I didn't like the love, I liked the climbers. Was no sister then, was running out of time and one-liners. And I was afraid, like you are when you're too young to know the time. And so I watched the way you take your fear and hoard the horizon. You point, you have a word for every woman you can lay your eyes on, like you own them just because you bought the time. You turn to me, you say, I'm not threatened, whoa, 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 I'm not that petty. As cool as I am, I thought you know this already. I will not be afraid of women. I will not be afraid of women. So now we're at a club, you watch the woman dancing, she's drunk, she's smiling and falling in that slow descending funk. The whole bar is loud and proud and everybody's trying out. You play the artist, saying is it how she moves or how she looks. I say it's loneliness suspended to our own like grappling hooks. And as long as she's got noise, she's fine. But I could teach her how I learned to dance when the music's ended. Whoa, 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 and that's not petty. As cool as I am, I thought you know this already. I will not be afraid of women. I will not be afraid of women. Try to make me doubt, to make me guess, try to make me feel like a little less so. I liked you when your soul was bared. I thought you knew how to be scared. And now it's amazing what you did to make me stay. But truth is, just like time, it catches up and it just keeps going. Whoa, whoa, whoa. So I'm leaving. Find out how much better things can get. And if it helps, I say I feel a little worse than I did when we met. So when you find someone else, you can try again. Might work next time. You look out of the kitchen window and you shake your head and say low. If I could believe that stuff, I'd say that woman has a halo. And I look at it and say, yeah, she's really blonde. And then I go outside to join the others. Whoa, 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 and that's not easy. I don't know what you saw. I want somebody who sees me. I will not be afraid of women. I will not be afraid of women.
Yay!
Woo! Dar Williams. In the studio.
Full disclosure, my folk group in college, I brought that song to them and we did it. So somewhere on Kenyon campus is like footage of me performing that song with the Stairwells.
Right on. Thank you, Kenyon.
And isn't it like an official song for like Bryn Mawr College or something like
it's
that?
It's for their Mayhole Festival. Yeah, which is fantastic. But it's so good. Like my first love, the guy who totally broke my heart, is a film professor at Kenyon. And I hope he heard it and he was like, wow.
If only I had stayed.
I had no idea, but now I'm going to say something when I go back to reunion.
Exactly.
Music lovers in the Valley probably know, Dar, that you have a long history here in the Valley. I think it was the mid-90s, 93 or something, that you moved here. What brought you to the Northampton area?
Well, I first went to Boston because all my friends, I was a theater person, my friends all went to New York and they were broke and they were just suffering. And my friend said, come to Boston, do theater here. You can get a cappuccino and a bagel for less than $2. And I said, okay, that sounds all right. And it just really wasn't a theater town. They cast everything out of New York and or out of Harvard and music. You know, it was like everywhere. I went to a song swap in somebody's living room. That was sort of my introduction. I had a voice teacher who, you know, I said, I'm interested in opera or folk. And she said, well, can't help you with the opera, but go to the Naked City Coffee House and see what the open mic is like. And it just went on and on. And then I just felt like it was just everybody's mind was getting very busy and very, you know, who's on what rung of what ladder. And I was like, there's really no ladder. Like, really, yeah. There's not a lot of, it's a lot of tiny rungs on a tiny ladder. So I came out here to make sure that my mind was clear to write and to have this wonderful, I mean, it's really great. You got 91 and you've got 90.
Yeah.
And I tell people, like, that really counts for your, you know, in a fuel-efficient car.
Yeah.
So I had all this space, all this love, all this kindness, all this great stuff, and all the inspiration of the venues. And this is where everything just took off. I mean, I really came into who I was here.
I remember hearing your song. I worked at a radio station north of Boston, and I was in love with your song, Are You Out There? And then I was working at the radio station WRSI in Northampton, and for the first time ever, it clicked. Are You Out There? Can You Hear This? Jimmy Olsen, Johnny Memphis. Jimmy Olsen has been on this show a million times, Signature Sounds Records, architect of the Green River Festival, Johnny Memphis, a great DJ. And that's such an homage to radio that really, it's one of my favorite songs. It really touches me and shows you how important radio can be in people's lives.
100%.
And also typifies so much about the Valley and that time frame, I think.
Yeah, they had Homegrown Wednesdays. Yeah. And so you'd come in, and I came in, and I just loved Johnny Memphis because he was all like, everything was cool. Whatever came, whoever, whatever, he made it cool. Like, all right there, you know. you just smashed your guitar. All right, that's a choice, you know. And so I came in, and then I did something for another radio station where I had a song that was one of their first songs on their fundraising CD. And they played that track on WRSI. So that's where I first heard myself on CD. Mm. And Johnny says, like, yeah, she's our hometown girl, but you know what? I think something's really happening here. Uh-huh. It was so, that encouragement meant the world to me.
Aww.